Live from NBC 25 and serving all of mid-Michigan, this is NBC 25 News.
We don't know what's going to happen, but why do they want the names? Why is it so prominent that they need the names, period?
Tonight, the debate over releasing the names of Oakley's reserve unit continues after the release of private donor names last weekend. Good evening, everyone. I'm Sadie Hughes. Thank you for joining us this evening. The Village Board in Oakley met tonight to figure out what to do next. Residents in attendance came with mixed opinions. NBC 25's Nikki Zizaza was at tonight's meeting and has the latest on the controversy. Nikki.
Sadie, things are heating up again. I spoke to several Oakley residents about the community's legal troubles and their opinions on whether the identities of Oakley's reservists should be released next.
If you're looking for Bill Sweatland on a weeknight, you'll find him here at the Family Tavern, downing a beer with his friends. He says he can't escape the town chatter about the police reserve unit he believes is not necessary. 100 reserve officers in this tiny town.
I just mind my own business and do my own thing, but I know, you got your sheriffs, you don't need all the other guys out here.
But in what's become a month-long battle in court over Oakley's large number of anonymous reserve officers for a small town, some residents at a special meeting argue the village is in need of a large police presence.
I've lived here for 40-some years. I've raised 6 children. You know, and I got 20 great-grandchildren, and we need a police force here.
High tensions as city leaders debate whether names of police reservists should be released after the village president revealed the names of private donors, which Evelyn says was more than enough.
What do they want them for to begin with? I mean, some of these people are donating money. That's how we got our playscape over here.
But Bill says in a town of less than 300, he can't help but question their motives.
They're not here to serve and protect. I mean, serve and protect's one thing. It's a business. They're here to make money. That's what I think.
Sadie, what's complicating the controversy and dividing the town is that one of the village trustees is suing the town for operating illegally. Tonight, the board introduced their attorneys and also admitted their funds are diminishing because of the mounting lawsuits that the town has been slapped with. Nikki Zizaza, NBC 25 News.